Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you very much for coming for the service of celebration and thanksgiving and for the life of Elsie Price. First of all, I send the apologies of the minister here at High Street Church, the Reverend Jimmy Warburton. Unfortunately, Jimmy isn't able to be with us today and had to put out last minute. So it's an honour to be able to come and to share the service today. I know that we're all very much thinking on the late today, the loss that you've experienced. The large crowd in the church today is echoing the support that people wish to give to you. We also extend our sympathies to Romain and to Ronnie, and to Julie and to Glenn, to Killian, Callum, Cara, and of course Sheila and Roy. And we're very sorry that Roger and Vivian cannot be with us today, but we know that they're watching here the video and from Hong Kong, and we send them our deepest sympathies to them. Thank you for following the various protocols and wearing masks and so on during the service, and but we do appreciate your patience with us now. Let us worship God. The Lord has given, the Lord has taken away, blessed be the name of the Lord. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. We pray together. Loving Father, we thank you that you sent your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ, to bring life and immortality to light through the gospel. We thank you that by his death, has destroyed the power of death, and by his glorious resurrection, he has opened the kingdom of heaven for all who will believe. We ask that just as we know that he lives, we will be assured that he will live also, so that neither death nor life nor things present nor things to come shall be able to separate us from your love, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord, in whose name we pray. We sing together our opening hymn. It's a version of the 23rd Psalm, "The King of Love, My Shepherd Is," who's been
I'm
reading today is from 1 Corinthians chapter 13. This is the word of God. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels but have not love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains but have not love, I am nothing. If I gave away all I have, and if I deliver up my body to be burned but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. As for prophecies, they will pass away. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part and we prophesy in part. But when the perfect comes, the partial will pass away. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. Thought like a child, I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I gave up childish ways. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then face to face. And I know in part, and I shall know fully, even as I have been fully known. So my faith, hope, and love abide, these three, but the greatest of these. This afternoon we have a few people in the family taking part sharing tributes to Elsie. First of all, I'd like to read out an account of Elsie's life that had been given by the minister, Jimmy. And following that, Rob Sherwood is going to speak to us in the recording, not be followed by Paul McCarran. Elsie Price was born on the 28th of June 1934. To parents James and Elsie McKenty. She grew up in White Abbey and went to Ballyclare High School. It was at school that she developed her love for sport, playing hockey throughout, and even contributing to play for Ballyclare Hockey Club after she left school. Art was another passion she had from a young age. She was an accomplished painter and kept this up as a hobby throughout her life. Elsie also valued community and was keen to help out wherever she could. She was involved in this congregation, singing in the choir and leading in the scout group. No doubt these moments were pivotal in developing her faith as a young woman. After school, she got a job working in the Northern Bank in Royal Avenue in Belfast, and this proved to be a life-changing move for Elsie because it was there that she met a man by the name of William Price. The bank was hosting a social event, a vehicle drive, and the two of them headed off. Billy and Elsie initially lived in East Belfast, but before long they moved into their home in Hollywood, where they have been ever since, and this is where the family grew up. And indeed, where many memories were made. Between the two of them, Billy and Elsie grew and nurtured the beautiful garden at number 1 Croft Gardens. Apparently Elsie was the true gardener of the two of them. She called the shots whilst Billy did the groundwork. While in Hollywood, they joined the congregation of High Street. Elsie was a valued member here for years, trying to help wherever she could, and such was her love for people. She wouldn't just wait for somebody to ask for help, she would notice a need and go towards it. Indeed, she was a regular part of the Young Wives Fellowship group that met and volunteered with a group of ladies who ran a lunch club at Spafield Fold for many years. As the years passed by, Elsie enjoyed many family holidays, several up on the North Coast, in Port Stewart, and Portmanatree, one or two cruising in Lochearn, and a few slightly further afield camping in France and cruising in the south of France. Billy was the planner, but Elsie made it all happen. Elsie's love of sport continued into later years. She loved golf and was leading captain at Knock Golf Club for a time, as well as being a member of the Royal Port Rush. And by all accounts, she was a distinguished golfer. And so we have some of the golfing fraternity here today. Billy was always happy to admit that she was the finer player of the two, and I believe she won a few prizes here and there, including on one occasion after her wonderful 41 points in competition. Ascension in Portugal.
The two of them travelled widely, laying off in their retirement. Sadly, all of this would change in 2012 when Elsie suffered a major stroke. That would bring many people down to the lowest of lows. Elsie showed her strength of character and resolve by soldiering on and showing a very positive attitude. Billy, her husband, devoted his life to helping her do so. And it was in this way Billy and Elsie were seen as inseparable. Everything they did together. Such was their love and their commitment to one another. Elsie's resolve through adversity became an example to others. She was a key contributor to a stroke survivor's self-management book, which has since been developed into an app. The story continues to inspire people throughout the UK about how to live life to the full after a stroke. And we think that Elsie indeed would be delighted by that, loving to help others. In fact, such was her kindness that she became great friends with many of her care providers in recent years. Elsie simply loved people, and most of all, she loved her family. Billy was by her side each and every day. Determined as ever, they headed out most days and frequented the many coffee shops here in Hollywood and East Belfast. Often to be spotted at the Mount, and more recently having a takeaway coffee when sitting in the car outside SD Bales. Sadly, in the last few weeks, Elsie's health took a turn for the worse. She was taken into the Ulster Hospital, and Monday evening she passed away under very peaceful conditions. She will be sorely missed by those who knew her most, not least of which by her family. And I'm going to hear some tributes from them. And Roger's recording will come first.
I just want to say thank you for everything. I'm sorry that I can't be with you today, so I'm sending this to you the only way that I can. Together with Dad, you gave Renee and Julie and myself a fantastic family of everything that we could have wanted or asked for. You introduced us to Gran, and with Dad, to Nana and Papi and then Sheila, thank you for that. You gave us a fantastic family house. We started out in Glenmillan, which we outgrew when Renee and Julie arrived, and we moved on to Hollywood, which we built up from the foundations, and this was our family home. I have happy memories of all of the holidays that we did together, Port Stewart, Port Rush, Port Ballantrae, Lochearn, and even in the south of France. Thank you for those. When we went to school, you helped us all the way. You drove us there, you drove us back, you made lunch for us, you did everything we needed. When we grew up and we moved away, as I did to the UK and eventually to Belgium and Hong Kong, you supported us all the way. I remember when I gave you the iPad, you had no idea what you were going to do with it, little did we know. When new family came along, you embraced that. Thank you for embracing Vivian and Killian and everything that you did. I know that the last few years have been difficult following your stroke, but I also know that you moved into a new and closer relationship with Dad. And I also appreciate that you and I kept contact every single day by words and messages. Thank you for everything. We will miss you enormously, terribly, but we love you very much.
We have no time to stand and stare. No time to stand beneath the boughs and stare as long as sheep or cows. No time to see when woods we pass, where squirrels hide the nuts in the grass. No time to see in broad daylight, streams full of stars like skies at night. No time to turn a bee's glance and watch her feet, how they can dance. No time to wait till her mouth can reach that smile her eyes began. A poor life this, if full of care, we have no time to stand and stare.
Cat poem, is it? One of Dad's favourite poems, and Dad recites poems and they recited it a lot as we grew up, so thank you, Cara. I'm just going to say a few words and then we're going to be sharing an amazing collection of photos that Cara's kindly put together, which have come a lot from Roger's amazing number of photographs he's taken over the years. But before we start, I just think it's an opportunity to thank people today. There's a few people I'd like to thank. I really want to thank everybody who's made it today. It's been difficult times, and to have so many people around us today, and even over the past few days, has been so comforting. And we just want to thank you for that. And we just want to thank you as well for some people having been able to be here today. You've mentioned Roger and Vivian, and also there's a few people I know that would have liked to be, like Jenny and Steffi, and Mum's lifelong friend Maureen, who is in Canada, can't be with us as well. The other big thank you I want to do today is to thank Care and the team who have been amazing over these past few years. We can't thank them enough, how they've been in so sweetly coming in the mornings at different times throughout the day to help Mum. Mum formed great friendships with them, loved their stories, and so many times we've said as a family we could not have done without them. And then over these last many months, there's new people have come in and out of our lives into the home to help, and we thank them as well. We're so grateful. And just a wee mention for the neighbours of Warren Park Gardens too, because they've been there helping Dad when he's needed it, even waving through the window during COVID times, arriving with bums and things like that. We thank you for that as well. But today we really want to be a celebration of Elsie's life and how she's enriched our lives. A celebration of Elsie, of my mum, of our Nana. And as I say, we're going to show you slides in a minute. What you're going to see is what Nigel referred to. The most important thing to Mum was her family. And as we went through all these slides, which took us a long time, and it's hard to condense into a short display here, there are many, many happy family members, memories of get-togethers in One Pop Gardens Hollywood, birthdays and anniversaries, trips to Belgium, you'll see. The other thing that comes across and reminded was Mum's amazing way to put together her meals. We had family meals, people, big numbers, and her cooking was amazing. She was always in the kitchen and made everything so effortless and came up with these amazing things. And oh, I've had a few messages over the past few days to say, I still cook your mum. Elsie's salmon pie is one of our family's favourites, and it's known as Elsie's family salmon pie. So her recipes go far and wide. The other thing was, there's always sandwiches, Elsie's sandwiches in the fridge. And if anybody knows, her sandwiches are amazing too. And even over these last weeks, Mum was, and I would have gone in the kitchen, she would butter the bread and still made her sandwiches. So we'll miss Elsie's sandwiches for sure. The other thing you're going to see is her style. I mean, Elsie is a beautiful lady, as you know. Her love for fashion, her love for clothes, her love for being coordinated, which is another thing. And there are wardrobes full of clothes in One Pop Gardens Hollywood. And even to the extent on Friday morning, whenever Saturday morning, the ambulance arrived to take her, and the lady said, maybe you could put a jacket on her. So I was sort of thinking, well, I'll just lift a old grey jacket, Dunn's coat. But as I brought it in, it was, I want my navy dash flowing in. So she had to be coordinated in her outfit, even on her way to hospital. So you're going to see her style. Things have to match. Her love for the garden, I think a few photographs of Prop Gardens will come up. As we, yes, it was a combined effort between Dad and Mum, but Mum's gardening skills were the best. And even, there was always pots at the front door, every the spring the bulbs coming up, and right throughout the summer she knew when to have things coming up. He was though that her begonias were always better and the best, and we always thought how she'd do it. So this year, Ronnie got the secret idea from her. She shared her story of how her begonias have been the best. So you'll see her flowers. So many beautiful words have come through to me from people over the past few days describing Elsie. Her kindness, how welcoming she was, beautiful. The words that kept coming through was she was a lady, a special lady, and she was such a pleasure to be in her company, and she was full of fun. And somebody reminded me of her dancing to ABBA at our wedding. The most important person to Elsie was Billy, and they are a couple. Wherever, I think it was last year, where Elsie was, Billy was, and I know she would be so missed. But Elsie will be missed by all of us and by so many of us here. But we want to be thankful today and be glad of those many memories that we have that will stay in our hearts forever. Julie's going to read a poem, again, just chosen by Carol, which I think will then lead in Nigel to the film with photos.
Remember me when I have gone away, gone far away into the silent land. When you can no more hold me by the hand, nor I half turn to go, yet turning stay. Remember me, when no more day my day, you tell me on a future that you planned. Only remember me, you understand. It will be late to counsel then or pray. Yet, if you should forget me for a while, and afterwards remember, do not grieve. For if the darkness and corruption leave a vestige of the thoughts that once I had, better by far you should forget and smile than that you should remember and be sad.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me, your rod and your staff that comfort me.
You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil and my cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. Let me pray. Father, I pray with the help of your Holy Spirit, the words of my mouth, and the thoughts and the meditations of all of our hearts, the next minute or two will be acceptable in your sight, our strength and our redeemer. Looking at the dates on the front there of the order of service, 1934 to 2022. That's remarkable. 87, coming 88, had your mum been spared to later this year. A long life. The first item of praise that we've been singing, the last verse, speaks of that. And so through all the length of days, thy goodness faileth never. Good Shepherd, may I sing thy praise within thy house forever. And that's based on Psalm 23, which we've just read together. And as I said, we're going to be singing the metrical version of Psalm 23 at the end. So it's wonderful that we'll be finishing with those words. And draw up that last verse to your attention, simply to leave two thoughts with you today. And that is, we're here in this place to look back, but we're also here to look forward. We're here to look back, and we're also here to look forward. We've had a chance of looking back, and those tributes have been wonderful. They've assisted us with that, hearing the poems read, looking at the pictures, getting the video for Roger, and so on. So it's a chance to look back and to say thank you. And we do it in the context of a service of worship, because we recognise that every good and every perfect gift doesn't come to us, we sort of pull up our socks, but they come as gifts from God. They're gifts from God. Those precious ties of kinship and friendship, life itself, all of those things are gifts from God. So we're here today to say thank you to God for the life of Elsie Price and all those memories surrounding her. And the psalm also encourages, when we're looking back, not simply to say thank you to God for physical blessings, but also think of the spiritual blessings in our lives. Here David talks about the Lord restoring his soul and leading him in paths of righteousness. So it's not just the outward things that we give thanks to God for today, but it's the interior life as well, lived in relationship with God. Now, as Christians, we believe that we can take this psalm and sing it for ourselves, just as David had penned it and sung it, because we believe that it's Jesus who is the Good Shepherd. He's come searching for us, the lost sheep. In fact, he's given his life up for us, the lost sheep. And having been raised from the dead, ascended into heaven, and from there he and the Father poured out the Holy Spirit upon us, we've been able to hear the message of Jesus for ourselves, as contained in the Word of God. And the Holy Spirit has worked secretly inside of us, giving us faith in Jesus. And whenever we place our faith in him, as David says in this psalm, he restores our souls. But he doesn't leave us alone. But the interior secret work of the Holy Spirit, and with the Word of God, he leads us in paths of righteousness. So that will also mean going through the valley of the shadow of death. But we don't need to be scared. But we're the Good Shepherd with us. He's gone before. He's right there with us, and he's behind us, surrounding us and inside us, the Good Shepherd. So today we want to look back and say thank you, and say the Lord is my shepherd, the Lord Jesus is my shepherd, he's restored my soul, and by his word and his spirit he leads me. And secondly, this scripture tells us to look forward. It's not like we've come to an end here and there's nothing beyond us. Thankfully, there's Christian hope. This is a celebration, not only of a life that has passed, but a celebration of what is to come. In Psalm 23, in verse 6, we read, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, looking back, and then I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
or as we've been singing. And so through all the length of days, thy goodness faileth never. Good Shepherd, may I sing thy praise within thy house forever. So whether our lives are long or short, that we can have eternal life through faith in Jesus Christ, that is, we can dwell in the house of the Lord forever. The resurrection of Jesus Christ guarantees the resurrection of his people who will live in the new heavens and the new earth and the new Jerusalem. And the wonderful thing about living there is that we are told and assured in the last book of the Bible that God himself will wipe away every tear from our eyes. Death shall be no more. Neither shall there be mourning, nor crying, nor pain anymore. The former things will pass away, and everything will be new. That's Christian hope. Let's believe it for ourselves. So we look forward to this wonderful future through Christ. So today, we've had a chance of looking back, saying thank you to God, and looking forward, thanking him for his promises in his Son, Jesus Christ, in whom we trust. Amen. We bow our heads together in prayer. Indeed, loving Father, we look back and we acknowledge that every good and every perfect gift comes from you, the Father of lights. We thank you for the gift of life itself. We thank you for those precious ties of kinship and friendship. We thank you for the pleasure of human affection and love. And today we thank you especially for our friend Elsie, whom you've taken from this earthly scene, for all that made her special, all that you gave to her, and all that she meant to those who loved her and knew her. We especially pray for Elsie's family, praying in particular for Billy, Romaine and Ronnie, Julie and Lynn, Killian, Callum and Karen, Sheila, Roy, Roger and Vivian, indeed the wider family circle of friends. We pray that as David was not scared of going through the valley of the shadow of the death, because the Good Shepherd was with him, we pray the family might know the presence of the risen Jesus Christ in their pain and loneliness and in that turmoil of emotions which death inevitably brings to those who are left behind. We thank you for this opportunity to look back and by the work of your Spirit in all of our lives, may we trust Jesus Christ and look forward to the new Jerusalem. And we pray in his name. And together we pray the words he has taught his disciples to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and the glory, forever and ever. Thank you so much for coming to the service today, and thank you especially to the family and for participating so well. We sing the memorable version of Psalm 23, The Lord's My Shepherd.
Thank you.
which passes all understanding, guard your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit remain upon you and abide with you always. Amen.